Duff here, in the car heading off to do a Ninebot One riding session. Early this morning, Cindy and I were just out on our Ninebot Segway Mini Pros. Did like a 6 mile ride around North Collier Regional Park, and that was very nice, very enjoyable. It was very hot, but the ride was great, very scenic. I hear some thunder, that's awesome. So I haven't ridden my Ninebot One since Wednesday, I believe. I took it to another park that's near where I work, and it didn't feel real good. My my legs felt super stiff. I didn't feel like I had really solid control. I wasn't wearing the shoes I normally wear, so it wasn't really an enjoyable ride. I didn't crash, but I definitely felt like I regressed a little bit on that ride. So I kind of theorized I might have had kind of just dead legs. I had done two runs in the span of 4 days and rode the 9x1 almost every day for like 4 or 5 days, putting in well over 20 miles. And my legs just felt bad, you know. I just didn't feel loose and I didn't feel like you should. Oh, I'm looking ahead here and we got a wall of rain. Awesome. Right around where I want to go, so I might be trying to drive somewhere else outside of the rain area. We'll see where I wind up. Turn off now. Definitely not going to be riding around here. I will continue westward. Okay, we appear to be coming out of the hard rain. Very common in Florida, you can have intense areas of rain followed by nothing. That area of rain there was probably about 2 miles square. And we're now out of it, and it looks like the sky is kind of blue ahead, so I'm thinking I might park around Dunkin' Donuts maybe. Maybe I'll ride around there. I've never done that on the wheel before, so see what happens. A lot of cloud in the sky. It's crazy, huh? Alright, here I am at the launching point. Behind me is our Dunkin' Donuts that we go to most often. Gonna suit up and get ready to roll. Okay, here we are cruising. Cruising on the walkway by canal. I'm not nearly as stable in 9x1 as I am on my Mini Pro, so be filming a whole bunch. But here I am. Don't feel too bad. Definitely feel better than I did the other day. I had running sneakers on, my feet like immediately hurt wearing those. With these boots, they support my feet better on these pedals. So it's a good idea. You have big feet. Okay. This is the same route I went on the Mini Pro with Cindy a couple weeks ago. Tire's feeling a little low. I think I need to put some air in it. Absorbs bumps, but I don't know. Just cruising. I don't feel as tight as I was the other day, so that's good. Still far from comfortable, but alright. If I itch my face or something, I still have issues where it's going to throw my balance off, which is good. Thank you. Okay, this is kind of the back end. With the Mini Pros, we did not go out onto this gravel. With the Ninebot One, I'm going to. Starting to fatigue somewhat, which is when this starts to happen. Alright, so far I have not stepped off once yet. Probably gone. Headwind. Suck if you were running or riding a bike. On a wheel, it's not so bad. Intersections are a little bit more challenging. You can't easily come to a dead stop as you can on the Segway Mini Pro. Luckily, there's not much traffic right now. Tried to hit the tilt back there. First time I really hit it. I'm happier going slower, to be honest with you. We're gonna stop right here. I broke my streak of unbroken riding streak. That's all right. I think they were gonna stop for me, but. Feet back in the pedals, they don't feel like they're pointed right, which isn't good. Okay, that ride was 4.2 miles. Average speed was 10.8, which is pretty good. And my total mileage in this now is over 40 miles, 40.7 miles. So this almost has as much mileage on it as my one Mini Pro, which if you had told me at the beginning when I first got the Ninebot One that I would have almost the same mileage as I did on the Mini Pro, I would say you are crazy. So, progress. So that was better than my last ride, which is good. I feel better about it. So we'll continue from here. For whatever reason, I'm technically right-footed. My right leg is my dominant leg, but I've been getting on it like I'm left-footed, where I have my left foot on the bot first and then hop on with my right. For some reason, that's felt comfortable. I haven't really tried to reverse that since I've gotten a little bit better at riding the wheel. So I'm going to try to hop on with my left foot instead of my right, see what happens. Weird. I'm not sure why that feels harder. But what I did notice is, like usually, when I hop on the way I normally do, left turns feel more difficult to me than right turns. But that time, putting my left foot on second, I actually felt like I could turn to the left more comfortably. It all has to do with foot position for me. It's really weird. Foot and leg position. So I'm gonna try this a few more times. Wasn't so bad. I just forgot to keep my left foot to the side of the pedal. I think the first time I had it behind, which makes it difficult to get on, so I went to the side, and that wasn't so bad. So I think I can do it either way. But it seems like what happens is the foot that I have on the bot first, I cinch up right to the side of it, and I think that is what causes it difficult to turn to that side. Because I noticed that then, once when I hopped on opposite feet, my turning problem reversed as well. So maybe I need to try to keep both feet off of the sides, like, because when they're pinned real tight, you don't have room to pivot as much, and that's kind of what feels like happens. So I need to mess around with that some more. But anyways, this was a good session, no falls, long ride. Back moving in the positive direction. Till next time, Duffman out.